Easter Sunday. Amen. Resurrection Sunday. Amen. 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 Can somebody just begin to give God a praise? Come on, you can do better than that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Truly, we just thank God for what he's doing and what he has done. Amen. Being able to continue ministry, not only here in the sanctuary, but also, amen, streaming live through media, those of you that are at home and in various places that still continue to, amen, pour into the ministry. We thank God for you, those of you that are in the sanctuary on this morning. Amen. Good morning. God bless you. So good to see you. Amen. Amen. Our scripture reading this morning is going to come from a familiar passage of scripture. Amen. It's going to come from John, starting at the 11th verse. John 20, starting at the 11th verse. And I'm going to go all the way to the 18th verse. Amen. And those of you that have your Bibles, your cell phones, your tablets, we ask that you stand in the reverence of the reading of the Lord's word. But Mary stood without at the sepulchre weeping. And as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the sepulchre and see if two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. And they said unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She said unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I have not where they have laid him. And when she had thus said, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus said unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, said unto him, Sir, if thou have borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus said unto her, Mary. She turned herself and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. Jesus said unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascended unto my Father and my Father to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord, and that he has spoken these things unto her. Amen.
Let's bow our heads. Most gracious Father, we thank you for this risen Sunday.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for all that you have done.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we come unto thee that we may give you glory and honor, yes. Lord, on today.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, bless your people, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Bless this service, Lord.
Yes.
Let us commemorate, Lord,
yes.
Oh, how you have risen, your death, burial, and resurrection.
Yes.
As the scripture has said, Lord, that you so loved the world.
Yes,
that you gave your only begotten Son.
We
thank you, Lord, right now. Jesus, we thank you.
Yes.
Lord, we pray, Lord, that you may bless, Lord, and bless, Lord, the nation on today, Lord. Oh, as they commemorate, Lord, what you have done for us, Lord. Where would I be, Lord, if it wasn't for you, Lord?
Yes.
Father, we thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, bless, Lord. Bless your holy name. Bless this service, Lord. Have the preeminence in it, Lord. Oh, Lord, help us, Lord, to glorify your name, Lord, and bless your name, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless the pastor as he bring forth the word, Lord. Let the Holy Ghost, Lord, be in the house, Lord. Oh, Father, we pray this in your name, Lord, and bless every, Lord, recipient, Lord, on today, Lord. Wherever trials they're going through, Lord, look in the hospital, Lord, and remember, Lord, our government, Lord, and bless your people as a whole. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So we've come to celebrate. Come on, somebody lift him up. Somebody give him glory and honor. Hallelujah. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Come on, it's a special day. Hallelujah. We've come to thank him and magnify his name. Hallelujah. Because of what he did for us. Hallelujah. We have the right to eternal life. Hallelujah. Because of his sacrifice. Hallelujah. Anybody want to just tell him thank you? Anybody grateful today? Come on, anybody really, really grateful? Hallelujah. For his sacrifice. Hallelujah. So we magnify you, King of Glory. We lift you up, King of Glory. We give you honor and praise because you're worthy, Father. You're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Inhabit this place. Hallelujah. Have your way, God. Have your way, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, the world will bow down and say you are God. Every man will bow down and say you are King. So let's start right now. Why would we wait? King of Glory, fill this place. Just wanna be with you. Just wanna be with you. I just wanna be with you. Just wanna be with you. Come on, you say, yes, the world.
Yes, the world.
Come on, say, we'll bow down.
Bow down and say you are God.
Come on, every man.
Every man.
We'll bow down and say
we'll
you are
bow
King.
Bow down and say you are King.
Yes, come on, say, let's start right now.
So let's start right now.
Come on, why would we wait?
Why would we wait?
We can praise you now.
We can praise you now.
Come on, say in victory.
In victory.
Lift it up, everybody. Say King of.
King of glory.
Come on and feel this place. Come on, say I just want to
be with you.
Come on, that should be our prayer today. Say I just want to. Come on, lift it up. Say King of glory.
King of
hallelujah.
Glory.
Feel this place.
This
I just want to be with you.
Just
want to be with you.
Just
come on, sing it again. Sing it again. Say King of glory.
King of glory.
Come on and feel this place.
Feel this
I just want to
be.
Lift it up. Say, King of glory.
King of glory.
Feel this place.
Just
want to.
Just want to be with you.
Come on, just want to be with you.
Just want to be with you.
So we'll sing hallelujah till you come again. Come on, come on. And we'll dance in your presence till you come again. Come on, all over the building. want to be with you.
Just want to be with you.
King of glory, fill this place. King of healing, fill this place. King to give him glory. Hallelujah. Give him honor.
Hallelujah. The King is here. He's here in the room. He's in the room. He's in the room. Hallelujah. Open your heart to him this morning. Open your heart to him. Hallelujah.
Kings is in this room. We bow down and worship you. The King of Kings is in this room. Be enthroned in our praises. King of Kings is in this room. We bow down and worship you. The King of Kings is in this room. Be enthroned in our praises. In the room,
we bow down and
we
worship
bow
down. King of Kings,
be enthroned.
Be enthroned.
King
of Kings,
King
of Kings, is in this room. We bow down and worship.
We surrender again.
King of Kings,
be enthroned.
Be enthroned.
We sing forever. You are
forever. You are
forever. You are.
Forever you are,
forever you are, forever you are King.
Forever you
we
are,
sing
King.
Forever you are,
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 forever you are King.
Forever
the King
you
of Kings,
King of Kings is in this
in the room.
We bow down and
we bow
you.
Down.
King of Kings, is
be enthroned.
Jesus,
the King of Kings,
King of Kings
in this room,
we bow down and worship
you. King
of Kings,
be enthroned,
enthroned in our
forever you are,
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 forever you are King. We sing forever you are.
Forever you are,
yes God.
Forever you are,
forever you are, King.
Forever you are,
yeah, yeah. Romans 12 and 1 says, "We beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present yourselves a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service." So Father, on this Easter day, the best we can do, the only thing we can do, is present our total worship, holy and acceptable. So we say, holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable.
Father, we present ourselves, holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable.
That is what we offer you. Holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable.
We need to be,
holy,
we gotta be,
acceptable.
You deserve it,
holy,
you deserve it,
acceptable.
Holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable, clap your head. Holy, acceptable. That's what he's calling for this morning. That's what he wants from you this morning.
your total worship, whatever that means to you, give it to him. We say holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable.
Father, we present ourselves holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
acceptable,
holy,
holy,
acceptable,
holy,
holy, acceptable,
holy,
holy, acceptable. Give him glory.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Amen. How many blessed people do I have in here today? Wave at me if you're blessed. Wave at me if you're blessed. And just tell the Lord, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. It's a wonderful thing to be in the presence of the Lord on this beautiful Easter Sunday morning. How many blessed people do I have in here today? Wave your hand if you're blessed. Amen. Praise team just sung so beautifully today, and we just thank God. I want to thank God for each of you today. Amen. We pray that this day will be a blessed day for you. Amen. God has plans. I want to call your attention to today's passage of scripture. Coming from St. Matthew chapter number 28. St. Matthew chapter number 28. If you can get someone to read for us, one of the brothers, brother, if you read for us, St. Matthew chapter number 28, verses 1 through 11. Today is a special day, because we come to recognize the grace and mercy of God. And you know what? God gave us a beautiful day. Amen. Somebody say a beautiful day. A beautiful day. Amen. And we have so much to be thankful. How many blessed people do I have in here? If you're blessed, wave at me if you're blessed. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. God is so good. Amen. Today we will address the subject of the resurrection of Jesus is significant. We need to know that the Lord has purpose for each of our lives. And I just want to thank God for letting us know that when he rose, we rose. Amen. And we have that assurance that everything is going to be all right. We thank God for the musicians and the mothers and everyone that are here today, because God loves you. God loves you. I'm going to ask if you read this passage of scripture for me, Matthew chapter number 28, verses 1 through 11. St. Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 through 11. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you.
In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week,
yes,
came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulcher. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it.
Yes.
His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men.
Mm-hmm.
And the angel answered and said unto the woman, fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen.
Yes.
Thank as he said, come, see the place where the Lord lay,
mm-hmm.
and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, all hail.
Yes.
And they came and held him by the feet and worshiped him. Then said Jesus unto them, be not afraid. Go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there they shall see me.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. How many blessed people do I have in here today? If you're blessed, just raise your hand. Amen. You know, it's a wonderful thing to know that God loves you and that he has already laid his hands on you and blessed you. Now, if you believe that you're blessed, let's just give God a praise for all that he did. He gave his only begotten son. Somebody give him a praise. On this special day, we tell him thank you because he didn't have to send his son. Hallelujah. And what I want to talk about today is the resurrection of Jesus is significant. The resurrection of Jesus is significant. And we have to know that when Jesus not only hung on a cross, but he got up from the grave after being crucified, and he has significance in our lives today because he makes a difference. Look at your neighbor and say, he makes a difference. He makes a difference. You have to know, you have to know that he makes a difference. And I want to talk to you today about the resurrection of Jesus is significant. It is important. A lot of folks don't know today that Jesus came and hung on a cross and died for you and I. A lot of folks don't know that. They just think it's another day. But today is a day to remember the sacrifice that Jesus paid for us. And a lot of folks don't know that he paid a price that we could not pay. We couldn't do it. We could not do it. So I want to share with you and help you to understand that the resurrection of Jesus, it wasn't so important just that he died, but that he rose from the dead.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody tell the Lord, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
You have power. You have authority. You have influence. Hallelujah. You make a difference because of the resurrection. See, a lot of people don't realize that he didn't just die. He rose. And because he rose, I have authority. I have power. You have authority. And that's why you have to know that he created you to be the head and not the what? Tail. He created you to be the leader and not the follower. Can I get a witness? God created you to make a difference. Hallelujah. So you have to know that you are not just somebody that's just passing by. You make a difference. How many of you know that you make a difference in your environment? Hallelujah. On your job. Hallelujah. In your community. The Lord created you. Hallelujah. To make a difference. The resurrection of Jesus. See, he died and was risen so that we might do the same thing. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. Let's look at five or six or seven reasons why it is important. The resurrection. The resurrection proves that the God that created heaven and earth has power, authority. You know what? If it wasn't for the grace of God, if it wasn't for the power of God, the enemy would take us out. He would destroy us. But you have to know that because God created you. Hallelujah. He proves to you that he has the power, hallelujah, to make a difference. He didn't create you to be an example of failure, but he created you to be an example of success. So I want to give you some reasons today. So, you see, a lot of folks don't understand how important they are. Let me see the hands of you who know that you make a difference in your environment. You make a difference. You make a difference. Your words make a difference. Your actions make a difference. Hallelujah. Whatever you do and say, make a difference. The Bible says like this. He created you to be the head and not the what? Above and not beneath. Somebody needs to understand and know that you make a difference in your environment. Young people must know that they make a difference in their environment. Wherever they go, whatever they do, hallelujah. The Bible says it like this. Ye are the light of the world. You make a difference. You are a city that sit on a hill that cannot be hid. You have to know that God created you to make a difference. Hallelujah. The first resurrection of Jesus proves the power of God. It proves that God has the power and authority to make a difference in your life. In your environment, sometimes I wonder whether some people know that they really make a difference in their environment. God created you. The Bible says it like this. He created you to be the head and what? Not the tail. Above what? Only. How many of you believe that? See, if we don't have the mentality to understand that we are important, let me see the hands of you who realize or who feel that you are important. Let me see your hands. You make a difference. That's why he gave you intellect. Somebody say intellect. Intellect, brains, hallelujah, ability, thought, hallelujah, power. Hallelujah. He gave you authority to be in charge, to be in control. And that's why he said in the Bible, you are the light of the world. Light of the world, city that sit on a hill that cannot be here. You make a difference. Look at your neighbor and say, you make a difference. Come on, look at him again and say, did you hear what I said? Did you hear what I said? Did you hear what I said? You make a difference. And some people don't realize that God has ordained you to be the head and not the tail. Hallelujah. Now, Jesus came into this world, hallelujah, and he proved that he had power and authority. They crucified him, but he rose from the grave. Can I get one witness? Somebody say power. Let me see the people here who believe that God has given you power and authority to be the head and not the tail. Let me see your hand. God created you to be the head and not the tail. Above only. Hallelujah. That's why he gives you intellect to be able to be in charge, to be able to be a leader, to be able to be somebody who makes a difference. Let me see the hands of you who believe that you make a difference in your environment. You make a difference in your environment. God created you that way, so that you would be known as somebody who make a difference. The first resurrection of Jesus proves the power of God. Let's go back to the Bible now. We know that Jesus rose from there. But the first resurrection proves the power of God. You know, God can give you and will give you power and authority to be the head of your class, young people. Hallelujah. To be the person that's in charge wherever you go. People will look at you and respect you and know that there is something special about you. Made you the head of your class. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. God wants you to know that he wants you to be the head and not the tail, above only. Hallelujah. To be an example so others can see you and become a follower and understand that God created you special. Let me ask a tough question here, a tough question. How many of you believe that you are the head and not the tail? You know what that means? That means that you don't have to be following somebody all the time. You have a mind. God gave you a mind. I want somebody to repeat this word, leadership. Come on, I didn't hear enough of that. Come on, one more time, leadership. God created you, and that's what we must teach our children. We must teach our families. We must teach those people around us. God created me to be the head and not the what? God created me to be the head and not the tail. And when people see you, that's why the Bible says you are the light of the world. Light of the world. Light brings illumination. Light brings knowledge. Light brings ability. And we have to know that God created. Let me ask a question here. How many people here who today believe that God created them to be a leader? Leader, you know, raise your hand high. Don't be. God created you to be a leader and not a follower. You lead the group. You have that ability. God has given you knowledge and ability, and he has given you that in place so that you can do the things that he called you to be. Somebody tell the Lord thank you. Let me give you, I think I have about six or seven reasons why the resurrection of Jesus is significant. See, the power, the knowledge, the ability, the gifts and talents that you have, some folks look at you, I hope y'all hear that, some folks look at you and they see, how does she do it? How does he do it? But when they really look close, they know that you have something special. How many of you know that God created you with gifts and talents and special? God didn't create you young people to be at the back of the class. He created you to be at the head of the class. The head and not the what? Hallelujah. He wants you to be, he wants you to know that. He wants you to act like that. He wants you to, when you're in school, work hard to get your grades where they need to be. Because, listen to this, there are scholarships for people who have ability. And somebody said, why? Seems like she's smarter than me. No, she worked harder than you. Maybe she studied more than you do. Maybe she's more serious. Maybe she worked hard so she can get an A or B. So when we put forth the effort, the Lord will give us. Let me ask this question. How many people here, young people first, how many young people here feel that you are blessed? That's how many are blessed. Now, how many of you feel that you're gifted? Gifted. If God said he created you the head and not the tail, hallelujah, that meant that he created you to be the leader and not the follower. How many of you here today see yourself as a leader, not a follower? Let me see your hand. Leader. Leaders are people who prepare themselves, who work hard, hallelujah, who have a plan, who do not just accept anything. They say to themselves, hey, you know what? I can do this. The Bible speaks to us and speaks to that subject. The Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who what? Strengthen me. The Lord has a plan. Hallelujah. And now, what we're talking about today is the resurrection of Jesus. Is it significant? Is it significant? Yes, it is. God wouldn't raise you up. The Lord Jesus wouldn't raise you up, hallelujah, this morning and give you strength and power and ability just to be average. God created you to be the head and not the what? He created you to be a leader and not a follower. So I'm going to give you reasons why now the resurrection of Jesus is significant. Why is the resurrection? When you really think about what the Lord did when he rose from the grave, he did what others could not do. And he said when he got up, he said, all power in heaven and earth is in my hand, is in my name. And I wonder how many of you get up in the morning and think to yourself, I am gifted, I'm talented. I have something to give. I have something to offer. And God created you to be that way. The Bible says it like this. He created you to be the head and what? Oh, come on, I ain't got nobody here today. He created you to be what? Head and not tail. Let me see your hand if you believe that. Created you to be the head and not the tail. He created you to be a leader. He created you to have folks to look at you and say, you know what? He's got something I want. And I want to be like that. I want to be the light of the world. I want to make a difference in my community. I want to be a difference wherever I go because God created somebody to watch me. He created me to be an example. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. So when Jesus rose from the dead, see, when they crucified Jesus, they thought they had him finished. But the first resurrection proved the power of God. What do you think I mean when I say that? What I'm saying is that Jesus was crucified, and now he is risen. It proves that God can make you the head of your class, the head of your group, the head of wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and you have to know, you have to believe that. How many, let me ask you a tough question. Brace yourself. How many people in here, I'm basically speaking to young people, how many people in here believe that they're smart? Come on. I can't see that. I can't see hands down here. If you believe that you're, the Bible says God created us to be the head and not the what? He created you to be a head, not he created you to be the one that folk are looking at. I got scripture for that. The Bible says, ye are the light of the what? A city that sit on a hill that cannot be hid. God has you in place for people to watch you so that they can see an example, so that they can see what the possibilities are. And we have to teach our children that. We have to believe that. We have to walk by that. Hallelujah. The first resurrection proves the power of God. It proves that God, even though Jesus was crucified, he got up out of the grave. Death couldn't hold him down. I need somebody here to hear this. There are things in life that you have to say to yourself. This is a statement that's in the Bible. I can do what? Through Christ who strengthened me. How many of you believe that you are the head and not the tail? Let me see your hand. God created you. He didn't create you to be at the back of the line. He created you to be at the head of the line. Created you to be the head and not the tail. Hallelujah. Second thing, hallelujah, he gave you the power to be an overcomer. The things that happen in your lives and my lives and all around us, that God has given us the authority and power to turn around. Hallelujah. You got to say, like the scripture say, let the weak say that I'm what? I got to say that I am more than a what? Conqueror. I am a winner. I am an achiever. Hallelujah. Now, Jesus had a purpose. Now, let me ask this question here. How many of you believe that you have a purpose for being on this earth? Raise your hands high so I can see it. Raise it high. Now, if everybody around you don't believe it, what should you do? You got to believe it for your what? You got to believe it for yourself. And you have to say to yourself, I am more than a conqueror. Jesus teaches us so much when he rose from the dead. They crucified him. But God had a plan for his life. How many of you believe that God has a plan for your life? Does everybody have to buy into that? No. You got to believe it and you got to know it for yourself. Jesus was crucified, hung on a cross. But when God touched him and told him to get up, it was time to get up. And I'm talking to somebody here today who need to know that God has a plan for your life. He called for you to be the head and not the tail. Above what? Only. God wants you to be the head and not the tail. Okay, the resurrection validates Jesus is who he claimed to be. There are some things that happen in your life that other people try to figure out. How did that happen? How did she get there? How did he do that? It's because the hand of God is on your life. You have to know that if God's hands is on your life, hallelujah, you have to act like it. You got to talk like it. You got to believe it. You got to walk like it. You got to say to yourself, I am blessed. I am more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. When they crucified Jesus, they thought they had him finished. But God told me to tell somebody here today, he has a bright future for you. How many people, and I'm going to ask you a tough question. I know everybody can't answer this because some folks are afraid. Are you smart? Raise your hand if you believe you're smart. If you don't believe it, who's supposed to believe it? Are you the head and not the tail? If you don't believe you're the head and not the tail, it won't happen. You got to have confidence in what God gave you. The Bible says he created you to be the head and not the what? Above only. As I look at this group of young people here, as I look at this group of adults here, I look at some intelligent people, people that God has a purpose for. And you have to teach it. You have to say it. You have to believe it. And you have to let nobody tell you what you can't do and what you won't be able to achieve. You have to believe it. The Bible even says this to the people who don't have it. Listen to this. The Bible says, let the weak say that I am what? Do you believe that? If you say you're strong, the chances of you getting stronger is possible. You have to know, hallelujah, they hung Jesus on a cross and thought they had him finished. Jesus went on. The question I have for you now is, do you know who you are? Do you know who you've been chosen to be? Do you know that you've been chosen to be the head and not the tail? I'm going to ask a tough question. I know everybody, some of y'all are afraid to answer it. How many of you in here feel that you are smart? Now, I need a switch for all the children who don't have. I need a long one where I can just. The Bible says, listen to what the Bible says. The Bible says, let the weak say that I am what? Bible wants us to know that if you can say it, it can happen. If you can't believe it, it will come to pass. But you have to say it. And parents, we have to say it to our children. We have to let them know that we expect them to achieve. Here's another tough question. I'm going to ask all our young people. You don't have to stand up for this. You can just wave your hand. Are you an achiever? If you're an achiever, wave your hand up. If you don't believe it, who's going to believe it? If you don't think it, who's going to think it? You got to believe. The Bible says it like this. Let the weak say that I am what? Strong. I ain't got no church here today. Let the weak say that I'm what? Strong. Amen. We have to believe it. And if you can believe it, it will happen. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. Okay. The resurrection of Jesus. See, when Jesus rose from the dead, a lot of folks didn't think he was going to get up. But God told me to tell somebody here today that you are an achiever. And if you can believe that, if you can think that, it can happen. I've got to believe it. You got to believe it. And we got to say it. And we got to act like it. We got to study. We got to prepare ourselves. We've got to do what we must do. And I'm talking to some smart young people here. That's why I'm saying this, because I know that God gave you all the ability. Okay, the resurrection of Jesus proved his sinless character and divine nature. Hallelujah. The scripture says God, the Holy One, would never see corruption. Hallelujah. Psalms 16 and 10. And Jesus never saw corruption. You know, the Lord can keep you and take care of you and provide for you and make you the head and not the tail. How many of you believe that God created you to be a leader? Do you need 15 people to tell you that for you to believe that? You got to believe that for yourself. You got to act like it for yourself. If the Lord wants you to be successful, if the Lord wants you to be blessed, he will open the door for you. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. Okay, the resurrection validates Jesus and fulfills Old Testament commandments. He said he'd make you the head and not the tail. He wants you to be the leader and not the follower. He wants you to know, hallelujah, that God is on your side. The resurrection validates Jesus and fulfills his prophecies. He says he'll make you the head and not the tail. Let me ask a tough question here. How many of you, just young people, how many of you believe that you are the head and not the tail? Young people. That means that you are a leader and not a what? Follower. You have to believe that. If you don't believe it, how's other folks going to believe it for you? What Jesus did, as we celebrate the resurrection, Easter and so forth, we celebrate victory over a lot of things that were going to come against us. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. You got to believe it. You got to believe that God's going to give you, when you get out of school, you're going to have a good job. You're going to be successful. You're going to do what God said. He's going to make you the head and not the tail. Now, Jesus, when he rose from the dead, he said, all power in heaven and earth is in my hand, in my hand. So that means that whenever you need something, you must go to the Lord, and the Lord will give you what you need. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. He's a healer. He's a redeemer. He make you the head and not the tail. When I think about those things, I recognize that he created me to be somebody special. He gave me the ability. How many of you believe that you can speak things into existence? Raise your hand again. God created you to be here so that others can understand that God created them to be the head. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. When we think about the things, you know what? God has given us the ability to ask. The Bible says, seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be open. Hallelujah. If we believe, the Bible says, all things are what? We have to teach our young people this. We have to believe that. We have to believe that I'm going to get a raise on my job. I'm going to I'm going to achieve more. I'm going to get the things that I've been wanting. He's going to make me the head. I'm going to get promotions. I'm going to be elevated. If I believe, the Bible says, all things are what? Possible to them that what? Believe. I've got to believe. Christ died and was buried and rose on the third day according to scripture in 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4. So that he might give us victory over anything that comes against us. The Bible says, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. How many of you in here believe that God has blessings for you to be leader and not follower? Head and not tail. Amen. And what God told me to tell somebody here today, if you can believe, all things are what? If you can believe, you can believe. God created you here to be the head, to be the light of the world. And you have to stand on that and understand that God has given you the victory. The Bible says, thanks be to God who giveth us the what? Victory. We have to believe that. We have to stand on that. So the resurrection of Jesus proves to us today that if we do one thing, ask. The Bible says, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be open. He will give you the desires of your heart. Because he created you to be the head. And parents, we must teach our children these things. We got to teach them that you're supposed to be the head of your class. God has given you what you need. The Bible says, thanks be to God who giveth us the victory. If you believe it, you can say it. And the Bible said, if you open your mouth and say it, it will come to pass. I challenge you today to believe God. How many, can I ask a hard question? How many smart young people do we have in here? If you're smart, just raise your hand. I can't see that far, so would you stand just for me? I can't see. I think somebody standing in front of somebody that I need to see. All the smart people, just wave at me. God created you to make a difference in your environment. Somebody's watching you. The Bible says like this, you are the light of the world. City that sit on a hill that cannot be here. Let's give all our smart young people a round of applause. Amen. As I close this brief message today, Jesus made a promise to us. He says, whatever you ask in prayer, in faith, you can receive it if you believe and stand on God's word. Hallelujah. And you have to know, if I pray, God will answer my prayer. Can I ask a tough question here? How many young people do I have in here that are smart? You have to believe that, young people. If you don't believe it, who's going to believe it? You must believe that you're going to be the head and not the what? Be the head and not the tail. God has a plan and a purpose for you. As we close today, we're going to prepare ourselves to lift our offering and tithe and remember that the Lord has a plan for us. And the resurrection of Jesus guarantees that God has blessings for us. Lift your hands as we pray. Thank you, Lord. Lift your hands as we pray. Thank you, Lord. Deacon Crock, would you lead us in prayer? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. As we prepare now to lift our tithe and offering, let us pray. Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for this time. Give us this day our daily bread, and bless us to believe that all things are possible to them that believe. God, we love you and we give you praise. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Benediction, we're going to ask Elder Lamont Johnson to give us our benediction.
Amen. Are you blessed today?
Yeah.
Are you blessed today?
Yeah.
Has God been good today?
Yeah.
Man, a beautiful message about leadership, about accomplishment and what you can do. Young people, you should have heard today what you can do in life and what God has for you. Amen. We should all know what God has for us in our place, Lord. All right, at this time, we're going to pray and leave and go and fellowship with our families and our friends on this Easter Sunday. Father, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for bringing us here on this Easter Sunday, Lord, 2023, Lord. Everyone did not make it to this point, Lord, and we give you thanks, Lord, and praise, Lord, that we're able to be here again alive on Easter Sunday, Lord. Lord, we thank you for all those who are here and present, Lord, those who are online, Lord. We thank you for this church, Cathedral of Faith Ministries. We thank you for our bishop and our first lady on this morning, Lord. Lord, as we leave this place and remember that your death, burial, and resurrection on this morning, Lord, and we take that with us, Lord, we ask that you watch over our families, watch over us as we leave this place, but not your presence, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, let everyone say amen.
Amen.
Families, amen. God bless you.